Hi guys, so today we will see how useEffect hook works and can be used in our application. So let's move and create a new component, called it as counter2.js. Make it as a functional component. Now how we have implemented what we have implemented in counter one, we are going to do same thing. That means we are going to have a count and a click button. So let's do it. So import use state hook from React. Now const count set count and use state pass initial value as a 0. Now we can render this here count count. Now let's have a button and called it as, name it as a click me. And on click, yeah, increase the value. So set count plus 1, right? As we expected, it will work. Let's import in app.js. So comment this one counter 2. Let's have a look. So you can see it's working fine. Okay. Now what I wanted to do. So I am clicking here and I want to display this count value in title. Okay. And after click me means when I will click, the value should reflect there as well. So let's import useEffect and useEffect is going to have a callback function. So here how to access the title. So document dot title and we will say here you have clicked, sorry, count value times and please print on console as you fail. So copy the message, same message we want to display here as well. Now have a look. So I am getting here you have clicked 0 times and here as well you have clicked 0 times. So if I am clicking now, you have clicked 1 time. That means the value is getting reflected. But just you come to code and you can see here, I am not calling this useEffect anywhere. But when the value of count variable is getting changed, this useEffect hook is automatically getting fired. Yeah? Have you got? That means when the variable, when the state of count is count variable is getting changed, so it's firing useEffect function and getting reflected there. Now so as I already told you before, useEffect hook can be used as a component did mount, component will unmount, component did update. So let us see that functionality. So useEffect hook is going to take second parameter will be array, and let's have a look. Now you may can see here you have clicked zero times. If I am clicking here, we are not, this change is not reflecting anymore. So I can see here count value is getting increases, but I can't see the title is getting changed or here as well. That means if the second parameter of useEffect is empty array, that will fire only once when the component is getting loaded. This is similar to component did mount in class component. In next video, we will see how to use useEffect hook in as a component did update, component will unmount. So guys, do like, share and subscribe. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.